CLEC. I learned about macro, because macro is key. I learned about ACM and scanning microscopy. I did not work on that, but I learned the experience, how it's done, how the scanning and the process is done. But I did hands-on on polishing, mounting, etc. And I worked on capsule materials and did a mathematical model and they submitted to that.
That's lovely, Shahid. So as I go through your CV, I find that you have certain hobbies also. So can you know in detail about your hobbies?
Actually, ma'am, I'm not really an extrovert. So I like to stay in my zone. In that way, I have certain hobbies such as photography, studying books. I just stay within my own world, basically. Like travel as well, to experience nature, people, culture. As well as, I like blending with people. Which you try. I can see all the success in that.
But that's a contradiction. You say you are not extrovert.
No, sir. No, ma'am.
You are introvert. And then you...
But ma'am, I'm introvert in reality. I cannot really express myself. But I tried.
Thank you, Shomit. So that was your round. So I would in detail now, I would carry on the discussion.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
So, can we have anyone else?
Derive a strength from them, because I believe your drawbacks teach you a lot in your life, And in the course of time, I found that I am quite hardworking. And if I do get due motivation in that subject, then I try to go in depth and derive the best from that. Other than that, I am quite inquisitive in nature. And I found since my interest lies in scientific and things which require logical determination and analytics, I took engineering and I found that I can flourish well over here because my strengths and my area of interest quite coincides with this side of academic curriculum.
One thing I would like to ask you, that you say that only with motivation. So without motivation, you are not a hardworking guy.
I believe that since a rudderless ship can't sail far away, and we all need something which keeps us motivating, keeps us driving, the driving force of life, and that comes with motivation. If you are aimless, if you don't have your own determination, and sometimes in life you have to find your own determination from your own. Nobody will teach you that. So I believe that yeah, one needs motivation to do something.
So should I mark you as a self-motivator or?
Yeah, I will say 80-20. 80% I am self-motivated. 20% the environment which I am in motivates to do something. Yeah.
Okay. So tell me one tough challenge that you have faced in your life.
Tough challenges, yeah, that's a part and parcel of life. Yeah, I did face tough challenges from class 7 to class 10, 7 to class 10. My father didn't just live with me and I was quite by myself on my own. So, and since I didn't have any tutors, I had to face everything on my own. My mother is also a working woman, so she couldn't give me enough time. So, everything that I did, it was quite a young age for me, and since I am the only child of my house, I had so much to do, the duties on me, which was on me, I used to tackle it on my own from that period of 3 years. And yeah, and since I said I didn't have any tutors, and in this world, I studied on my own, I did my own chores, I did all the requirements of filling the bills, paying the bills, I did on my own, so yeah. That I consider a challenge of my life and I excel at it. Yeah.
Thank you,
Pradhani.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So, it was lovely. So, I think if I ask for your opinion from this speech, what happened? How do you feel? What did you learn? Anybody is ready to give an open feedback? I think they will not mind. They are very sporting people, both of them. So will anybody mind giving a right feedback of how did you feel the interview session went?
I think it should be shorter.
Which portion?
I don't think the school portion should be mentioned. I think focus on skills and projects should be the priority. And strengths and weaknesses, that's it.
Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone from there? So okay, that side, the second year the same. So then let's move on to what this interview session. What is basically this interview session means? You know, in a country like India, we say that it's more it's not a selection round; it's more an elimination round. Okay, so because it's an elimination round, the interview you have to really groom yourself. You have to be very prepared for the interview because you don't know that what the other side could be asking. But then, this is particular framework. Beyond that, normal set of interview doesn't go until and unless this exceptional something happens. So basically, in an interview, while the interview takes place, it's a process where your intelligence is tested. So intelligence is not something super intellect question, but even day-to-day life question, how you answer. tested is your patience level, your tolerance level, okay? Because often today's youth are very impatient, they want everything made fast because digital world has made them very fast. So very quick, quick, quick. So that is also a stress testing. Because you are not hired in an organization just for 1 month, 2 months. So organization hires you with a long-term perspective. So they would like to see how they can groom that individual. And that is another thing that works now, whether you are fitting with the culture of the organization. Every company has their own type of culture. Okay. So that's what the recruiter or the team panelists who come, so they try to judge whether you are culturally fitting the organization. So that's what was the interview process, the reason for the interview process. Now the question is that, so to appear for the interview, you need to do homework. Often, what I have observed is that the homework is very limited to one aspect. The homework has not been done in all parameters. So the first homework is that to study the JD thoroughly. That's a very important thing that you should know. And one thing I would like to mention is that this session is not just for the campus recruitment. It is something that I'm here to really groom you that going forward also, when you all will go up the ladder, you should know that how you should present yourself. You should know how you should define your CV. And today, things are changing very fast. So I'll come, there's a section where I will be discussing about the CV. Now, you should study the JD very well. It should be well read. Then the company, how the company is dealing, what are their core domain, what the company has achieved, what has been their milestones. So you should see the company profile, the team in the company profile. That you can, today's world, you can see it in LinkedIn, you can see Glassdoor review, you can see review in Ambition Box. So the three places you can see very well that how the company is doing. Because you cannot just go blindly to a company if you have really a mission in your life. And also you should know the industry-specific questions. Industry-specific questions, how is the industry performing? What is the, for the IT people, what is the latest technology that is going up? For the ceramic people, that also that things are changing. So they should know that what is happening today in the industry. And the most important thing is the subjects that has been taught. For the campus recruitment, it's a general thumb rule that it's not asked something which is not being taught. But the problem is that what is taught, when we ask those questions, we find there's a huge drawback. What's written in the CV, we ask the question on the same technology, the same domain. But we find the basic fundamental questions are not being able to be answered by the candidate. So that's the thumb rule, is that please, when you sit for the interview, study your subjects. Don't tell a fourth year that if something is asked from the first year, that you've forgotten that is a first year question. Because I get to hear all these things. That's why I'm saying that please, before you sit for the interview, get yourself prepared with the subjects. Get yourself prepared with the basic questions. And those who have done internship, they should be thorough with that internship product. They should be, if you have done fact copy paste, then you will be in trouble during the interview round. So, and last is that something about some general knowledge about current affairs, about industry trend, certain GK. So that is what the homework that needs to be done. Now, let's see an interesting interview session. So I will show you a movie clip. So I would request everyone to see the movie and take down your conclusion.
दादा मूवी को करना होगा सर उधर है दादा एक बार पूछिए ना तो क्या करूँ? तो दिखे दिख नहीं रहा वो लोग. या तो लाइट कोई सर से पूछिए. वहां से रिकॉर्ड करते हैं.
आपके मार्क्स कंसिस्टेंटली पुअर है, कोई खास वजह?
बस बचपन से ब्राइट स्टूडेंट था, माँ बाप को लगा ये हमारी गरीबी मिटाएगा.
I think all of you have seen this, but we're seeing it from the perspective of our candidate. So you're seeing this time as a the interview. So what has been your observation? Tell me that.
Corporate colors are basically white, blue,
joined every guys of your age always with beard, so that's a good thing. So while you attend that interview, it has to be clean shaved, or else if you are keeping beard, that has to be well trimmed, formal type, clean pressed shirt. Don't put on crumbled crushed shirt and closed buttons, and your belt and your shoes are very important. Don't put on some jewelry belts. The belt has to be corporate belt with the color black and brown. Those are the two specific colors for belt. And the shoes should be polished. So that's a dress code that I had mentioned. Now another thing that I would like to address is that while you enter the room, be very careful about the perfume that you have used, the deodorant that, do use that, but don't use pungent perfumes, okay? So, but do use deodorant because your body odor should not come. Otherwise, the interviewer would feel how quick they can get rid of you. And as I have already mentioned, the hair should be neatly tied and combed. While you enter the interview, please keep your mobile switched off, not even in vibration. For that half an hour, 45 minutes, you should keep your mobile switched off. The folder that will be, you should be carrying your folder. The folder should also be a professional folder. It should not be a transparent folder. It should be a folder with a chain, and preferably again, it should be either black or brown. And the folder should carry all your certificates systematically kept, and also your CV. Now that CV is a very, very important portion which I would like to say about CV. The CV should be one page CV, not an elaborative CV. CV should also have the photo which is of the present age. Don't give your photograph of first year when you are coming in fourth year. Okay. The CV photograph should also have, should be in shirt. It should not be a round neck t-shirt. So that is also an important thing. Another important thing that this pandemic has taught us, the CVs should be AI enabled. And what is that AI enabled CV? Because when the mass hiring goes on, or even if it is a 10 candidates have been called for, the 10 candidates that has been shortlisted, their CVs should be AI enabled. And AI, how can you make your CV AI enabled? When you know the JD and you know the skill sets that they are asking, those specific skill sets has to be mentioned on the CV, which would go for a for ATS drive. Okay, because the recruiters will put the CV in the ATS, and those skill sets will come up. So you should know your skill sets, those prominent skill sets. Again, at the same time, if you have read the JD, then prepare your skill set as per the JD, because the JD will give you what do they need. Also, I was one of the CVs that please make your name of the institute you are passing, the from the year you are passing, and the score in a very prominent pattern. It should not be that I need to search, because one of the CVs I had to search that where is the score that the person has got. So it should be transparent. And a very important thing is that this is not, may not be right now, but going forward when we'll be changing and hopping from one company to another company, never quote the projects that you have done in that organization, in the last organization, because never quote the name of the project, because the name of the project, it is the patent of the company, and you should not deviate from that NDA Act. So you can write the pattern of the project. I have made such an app. Sorry, I am quoting IT because I am more from that domain. So I have made a mobile app, a prototype of Zomato or prototype of other Swiggy or something, Uber, Ola, but you would not be mentioning what was that particular app. And the very important thing, the CV should be well planned. Okay, I have recently went for a campus hiring where I found a couple of CVs just half page. The moment we saw the half page into CV, we felt like not to call that guy for the interview. The CV and CV should not have any spelling error or grammatical error. So please do that check. Today everything is available digitally. And don't fake in your CV. Okay. Don't try to hide anything. If there is a 2 year year loss in between, or there is a gap, please be very clear in writing. Because because people, when they don't write the year of passing, that very moment it strikes that there's somewhere some problem, and then we start pre-candidate with that aspect. So don't try to fake or make up in the CV. You don't do that. So that was the CV portion. So as you enter the room, and the first thing that one should have is a big smile, okay? Not a worrying smile, not a excessive giggling smile, but a smile, okay? Which is very important. And then before you enter the room, you need to take the permission. May I come in, sir? And once the person says the panelist or a single interviewer says yes, then please take their permission. That, can I take my place? Say, please sit down. And when you sit down, ensure that you may be having your file or dump it on the table. Okay? Put it on your lap. If you have a chair beside, then keep it over there. Don't dump it. Okay? So these are very minor things, but you forget. At that point of time, out of tension, you forget. So what you can do is that you can rehearse among yourselves. Okay? That how should I sit? Then, as we have already said, then gently sit down, put your file, and also carry a pen which is working, because you never know that the interviewer may give you something, a pen, and then asking a pen, sir, can I have a pen? That looks you are not prepared for it. Then every time the interviewer is going to judge you on your behavior, on your preparation, on your promptness of handling things. So now, the final thing that all this thing is about judging the body language. What, by grooming yourself properly, what are you trying to do? Your body language is something which is very important. When he was asking me that I cannot show that attitude. Yes, you cannot show that attitude that I am going out to. I don't need the job. But then again, the attitude should be confident but polite. Okay, that's a very thin line. It should be confident but polite. It should not be an arrogant attitude. So you should be firm with what you are saying. Recently, I was in another campus recruitment where the technical round was over, and it was quite late. It was almost around 10 at night. So I was also tired. The team was also tired, and the students were. So one of the students, I really liked him. When I asked him that how was the interview and what was it that you had learned through this interview process, so he said, the best part of my interview is that, very politely he said, not at all arrogant, that he had replied something and which the panelist had said wrong. He challenged the panelist, and then the panelist said, yes, the candidate is correct. But the whole process has to be in a very polite manner, not with a sense of arrogance. Okay? So that is what you should, if you are confident about your deliverables, if you know your subject, you can challenge the, because at times the interviewer will brief. So, and the important is be upbeat and positive. Never have a negative impact, negative words or negative thought process that will be reflected. The words should be with confidence. And how that confidence comes? When your voice is the key point. The voice should be firm, the voice should be composed, the voice should also have the energy level. Okay? So that's the significance of the body language. So now that this portion is over, so now how many of you have till now attended campus recruitment or have attended any interview? Can you share your experience? Can you share your experience? How was your experience? Please.
So I've mostly interviewed with startups for internships, and the interview, because it's a startup, like they have less protocols in the interviews and they're more focused on skills rather than your core subjects in education. They just want your, like, whatever they need from you, like a skill set. So they grill you on that, definitely. And that's
what did you learn from the interview?
I learned from the interview experience with two different companies. One was a very small early stage startup and one was like a kind of a funded startup. So what I learned was, as the company grows, the more like protocols they establish, the more informal and the more formal the interview becomes. And if it's a small company, the interview is less informal, it's more like a conversation. And as the company size grows, it becomes more formal and there are more etiquettes and protocols to follow. That's what.
And were you well conversant with the procedures?
In the smaller company, like, it was very, it was not that much clear about the procedure. Like, they were more like off-the-shelf hiring stuff. Like, they didn't communicate well. Like, I would say that as well. But in the bigger company, they are like very formal with the professional HR sending me emails and stuff like that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Anyone else would like to share? Yes, please. So I've given interviews in like five companies and most of them were tech startups from Hirex and LinkedIn. What I have learned is like whenever I'm giving an interview, I just focus on myself and what I know. If I don't know any question, so I politely say that I don't know this because I'm just applying for an internship and I don't think that they should expect a lot of attention from an intern. Definitely not at the level of a full-time employee. So that is what I've learned, that focus on your skills, focus on your projects, be thorough with the projects, be thorough with whatever you have learned. And yeah, that's it.
So it's all more or less on the startups, not anybody with a process driven. None of you have passed the process driven.
No, I'm from third year, so I've only applied for internal elections.
I think he has also. Thank you. You have also, if you are raising your hand. So what has been your experience?
Well, my experience was so good that whatever I learned, I have appeared for only two interviews. In the first one I was not selected, but I was selected in the second one. So from the first one where I was not selected, I learned that you should have that confidence in the table and you should not show your nervousness to the interviewer, whoever taking your interview. And another thing that is, being honest is the best thing in an interview table. If they are trying to convince you in another way, don't go and don't tell lies for convincing them. Just try what it is true to yourself and they will know what is true or what is false. If they are asking some questions to me, they know that what should my answer should be. So this was the main thing that I learned from that interview.
Is that your thoughts also here?
Yes.
Thank you.
My interview was good, but that time I was nervous.
Why were you nervous? Did you make it? Things asked which you were not prepared for?
The first thing that my English is not very good.
Okay.
I think that even.
So, for that you have come over here, what is your expectation? What are you trying to learn from here?
How to get an interview.
Studying more, doing something innovative work can be your passion.
cooking can be your passion, but listening music, that's a random. Watching Netflix, they come across that sort of an answer also. So those are not hobbies. Okay. So hobbies is also something, remember, since the first thing I said, you say that do your homework before you come for the interview, that hobbies also make it such a way the hobby which is relevant for the organization. Which is that your development is something which the company needs, some hobby which will be. Maybe the hobby is making you proving that you are very hardworking, you are a determined person. Okay. So that is a very important thing. But be careful of the HRs, because they put that trap to make you feel very comfortable and relaxed, whereby you would start sharing everything. Okay. So be very precise that what you need to share and how much you need to share. So then then I would like to go for a few quick questions that I was asking them also. So these are the quick questions that you will always face. Some way or other you should face. So what is that? The first question is that, what is your strength? Now when we ask this question, or when the interviewer asks, what is your strength? So what they are trying to see is your intelligence, your honesty, your integrity. These are the things that, and how much you are adaptable, how much you are flexible, how much you are a team player. That is how they would like to see. And whenever you say something that this is my strength, be ready with an answer of justifying that. If I am a versatile person, if I am saying I am a versatile person, so what is the action of versatility? How? What are the things that you have done to prove yourself that you are a versatile person? That maybe you are very competent in playing cricket. At the same time, you are a very good designer. But though you are from ceramic school, maybe you are a very good web designer. So that is what I am trying to say. That if you are saying versatile, it has to be backed up with logic. Don't say just what, because you will be grim. How do I? You have to validate that. So if you are saying, so what basic strength that normally one should. Now since I am sharing that, please see that all of you don't quote the same thing. Otherwise the panelists will very well understand that you will have learned it. So result oriented, where you are determined, where you are an open minded person, if you are a close minded person, the interviewer will take a back foot. If they find the question that there's a rigidity in that person, they will take a back foot. So your answer should be, and how you love work and how you enjoy doing work. So that is what that your strength should be. The next question is about what is your weakness? Now don't tell that I don't have any weakness. Okay. So all of us have weakness, like this video that we have seen. So weakness, that should be converted into something positive. Okay. Like if I say that I'm extremely passionate about work. Now then, what's wrong in that? So you're passionate? So I'm so passionate that I forget to take my food on time. Or maybe because I'm extremely passionate, I expect the other person in my team, and thereby maybe I'm little hot-headed with them at that much of time because I want to maintain my deadline. So what is happening is that basically you are saying something negative, but it is turning out to be positive. You are channelizing it into a positive form. So whatever negative, whatever weakness you would like to share, but make sure that you convert it into your strength. The other question that again if you are being asked is that, why I should hire you? So this question also, why I should hire you, you should be thorough with the JD about the company, and then you should be aligned. Be prepared, because these are the questions that is definitely being asked. Why I should hire you? So you should hire me because I'm very hardworking. There are a lot of organizations who need hardworking people. Why should I hire you? So you must have seen some case study in your organization. Or you hire a hardworking, how that will contribute to the company. So that is another question, that why should I hire you? Then the next question that you often is being asked to all of you is that, where do you see yourself 5 years from now. So where do you see yourself from? So don't go out to, if you have anything to say, please come up to the stage and please contribute. I would love to hear. Anything you have to share? Anything? So I think then the session is going to monotone as boring. So I think for some time, let me hear from them. Then you tell me, if I ask you that where do you see yourself 5 years from now? What is your answer? Yes? Where do you see yourself 5 years from now? This question can be answered even by the second years also. So all of you have a dream. You have come to this college, you have joined engineering with a passion. So why do you see yourself? Yes, there's no one answer. So you can be innovative.
My name is Rishabh Jain and I am from 4th year city, 7th technology. The answer of this question may be like this, that in 5 years I see myself working in a corporate job in your company or in any other company of the organization. This can be a simple approach to this question.
But then how do you want to grow yourself with my organization?
For this I have to see the background of the company and see if I can be in any of the positions of the company that is required to me or that suits my own self. Then I can expect that in position or that position to that HR or that interview panel so that they want me to have me in their organization.
Thank you. So basically when this question is asked, what we try to figure out is that whether you are here for a short-term planning or for a long-term planning. Long-term association, today's world, we don't expect anybody to be not more than 3 or 4 years with an organization. So that's the trend of the IT industry, not to be more than 2 years also. So what the panelist or interviewer is trying to find out, that what is your planning with us, and that is what the assurance, that how you can assure us that yes, you will be here for certain years. Can you please give us how you are here now? Don't take talk about beyond 5 years. That 10 years or 15 years, sometimes I have a dream to be the CEO of a large organization. No, it's right now for going forward the 5 years, how you are planning your career path. Again, for this answer also, you need to know the organization. Need to know somewhere. And how do I know the organizational growth? How do I know that what's the ladder of the organization? The LinkedIn. You need to find out who are working with that organization. Who are your colleagues, would-be colleagues in that organization. With LinkedIn portal, you can get everything. So you can find out something about that, what is the company, how they do, and you will be prepared then that what should be your career path in the next 5 years. So that's the first round of question. And then of course the quick question that we keep on asking, the answer should be ready. Obviously, one of the big questions that I ask, who is your role model? Okay, honestly, trust me, not interested in knowing who is your role model. What we're trying to figure out, how quick prompt you have an answer. Okay, and who is your role model when you say, what is the reason for the role model? That is the answer that would define you. What is, why, if my father is very recently, I asked a candidate, who is your role model? Said my dad, I'm very happy. Okay, good. Dad, no, why? Blank face. So I think that's kind of, I've been talking for quite a long time, so I think if you people talk, that would be better. Or what I can do is that I can show you another interesting movie. So let's see that movie, and then now this time movie, I will be asking each of you, what is your observation?
This is actually 2700, Impolite people make me angry. injustice and does not give me what is my due.
Sorry?
When somebody does some injustice and does not give me what is due.
Okay. So the patch is having such conflict, seems so. So that is why. So the question is that, yes.
The missed opportunities.
When you miss opportunities.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
Your anger is directed towards yourself.
So the question is that, that's a one sentence answer. But how, what, do I conclude? Should I conclude that, okay, that this person is missed the opportunity, so he's not positive minded? Yes. So the anger which you can quote in a way that it turns out into a positive. I get angry when I find people missing their deadlines. And thereafter, the anger becomes a justifiable anger. Okay. So the anger, this anger would make you that, yes, you are a hard-pressed person who maintains the deadline. So like, one of you had shared the missing the opportunity, he said, and what did you say, sorry?
Injustice.
Now that injustice, again, that means when I fight for justice.
It's a very vague term.
It's a vague term. Obviously, you can be good. Give me an example.
Let us say, I have worked in an organization and I have completed a project, my team has completed a project and we haven't received neither the pay nor the certificate that we were promised. Something like that might be a justifiable source, but I think this is not like, in the interview we should not be mentioning something like that.
Yes, it should not be negative.
Yes.
But the question is that, if such incident brings anger, but then it can be that thereafter you have taken such an action. Thereafter, you have taken such an action of being persuasive. Okay. Yes. So that is what you should all learn. But you should be ready with these questions. Okay. So, this is enough. And, like, what is the toughest decision you ever had? So, I had asked him, so, what is the biggest challenge or the toughest decision? So, toughest decision is something which would make me understand that when this corporate life is completely a different one. Okay, corporate life will give you challenges where you cannot go to your faculties and cry that this has happened, that has happened. You have to be problem solving. Okay, so when I'm asking you the toughest challenge, then the toughest challenge has to be something that that tough challenge that you face, what through that have you been able to bring out your courage? Have you been effectively, have you been applying a solution for that, a result for that? So that is what the toughest challenge means. But then, it should be genuine. Don't try to, if you are making a story, then story should also look like genuine. Okay? So story should not be something, a muddy, messy story. Okay? The toughest decision may be getting admitted in this college, because while you are in that interview session, first of all, there's always a back and nervousness box. So impromptu, you tend to give a wrong answer. So the toughest decision also is something which is related and which will again bring out one of your personality. So that's the first set of questions. And a quick question I would ask all of you to be ready. Be ready. What is the last movie that you have watched? What is the last book that you have read? And if you say I don't read book, fair enough. But if you say that you are reading this book, it should be a genuine one. Because there can be one of the panelists who is an ardent follower of that writer. The person can ask you. Or the person can ask you what have you learned from that book. Or what was the thing that, not that everything is learning, but something that you have enjoyed from that book. Another question is that, tell me a mistake that you have done. So, tell me a mistake that you have done. Have you done any mistake or you have not done any mistake? Somebody said yes, I heard. You have done a mistake. Okay, no, not, but have you done any mistake? From that, I can't see them, but that set of a lot of you guys are sitting over there, so none of you have been very participating. So, have you done any mistake?
Like,
mistakes. So there's a real great chance. I think we should all add. Yeah, please, don't feel shy. If you feel shy, then the session will have no meaning. So how do you know it's not worth discussing? So what will you answer when this sort of question comes? Then what will you answer? So if you made a mistake, or that's also part of you. You made a mistake. So what mistake you made, and what rectification or what learning you had?
Learning, ma'am, like it was waste of time. That's what I have
learned. That's a good learning.
Yes,
ma'am. So no wrong in that learning.
Yes, ma'am, but like that was a mistake, and that's what I've learned, and I'm trying to rectify that.
So how are you trying to rectify that?
By investing in learning some new skills and developing like communication skills and all. So
that's lovely. That's a very good answer. That's a very good answer. So he has converted a challenge in his life by making it into positive. So anything, anybody from this section? Any mistake that any of you have done? You know the first thing that once you do a mistake, what is expected or what the interviewer is trying to figure out? Whether you have shared it with somebody, the first thing, because that when you share that, it needs courage. So that means the person is honest, the person is courageous. Okay? Like I will share one of my tremendous, blunderous mistake of my life of issuing appointment letter. And while it's all cut, copy, paste of today's word. So I was doing cut, copy, paste on the issuing offer letter. And I didn't realize that when by mistake the resignation clause, the number of days that the employee is supposed to serve, I have, instead of 60 days, I have made it 30 days. And it was a tremendous blunder. Had any of those team had resigned, they would have come up to the management and say that I have a 30 days notice. Ma'am, I've given me that permanent letter. So that was a, and why did I make that mistake? Obviously, maybe I was not 100% alert at that point of time. Well, I was maybe, I would rather say that I was not 100% sincere. Okay. So what I immediately did is that read all the appointment letter that I have issued in the last 1.5 months and checked and find out which are the appointment letter I made a mistake. And immediately I called them and apologized, and I immediately, fortunately, I don't know why, none of those guys had read that clause. So that's what, when you get the appointment letter, please read the clause of the full. So no mistake from anybody, right? So that was my mistake that I had shared with all of you. So I think, Vandita, did you share any mistake of yours?
My mistake was during my undergraduate, I was very selective about the colleges that I wanted to study in, and I did not apply for any of the mediocre colleges. So lastly I got into my dream institute, but the point is that before making any decision you should be well aware about it. So that was my mistake.
Thank you. So that's a past mistake which makes us learn from it. In future, we would not be repeating that same thing. So, so then, almost coming to the end, I would like to ask one of a question that also comes. How do you handle criticism? I would like 10 volunteers to answer. How do you handle criticism? Not these, they are quite participative. Somebody from this section. Yeah. How do you handle criticism? So you appreciate being criticized? So the question is that, how do you rate the interviewer? It should say that you have done a wonderful reading, and I think, sir, in your team, whoever would be joining, they would be a perfectionist. So the toughness, maybe mentally you say, oh my God, this guy is screwing me up. But then, again I say, diplomatically, how you bring out the positivity from that question. So that is. And another question, have you ever heard any negative about the company? Have you ever heard any negative about the company? Particularly with IT startups, you can get a lot of reviews in Glassdoor, and you have read that? So? No work-life balance. What does work-life balance mean? Yes, but then you have to define what does work-life balance mean. So all of you are aspiring that you should have a work-life balance, right? What is work-life balance? So work-life balance is something as a very big subject, but then work-life balance also saying that you're capable and competent in completing your work on time. You believe in that an efficient person doesn't need to work beyond 9 hours. An efficient person doesn't need to. One has to be efficient. Okay. Unfortunately, one of my tenants who was working in IBM, and he said before leaving Calcutta, he was from outside Calcutta, and he came down to Calcutta, and while leaving Calcutta, he said, the problem with Calcutta culture is that there's too many times that the morning till 2:33 is constantly going on from smoking session. Okay, so repeat your smoking session. From 2:30 then they would try to say, work on Maja, work on it. There's so much of their time. Okay. And then they would linger it to number of hours at 1:30, 2:30, 3:00 predominantly 97. So, which implies that the person is not efficient. So if you're efficient, can deliver or complete your work within 9 hours. Right? So that is the work-life balance means. And work-life balance importance is also that you need to know. So if you are asked that today I would be hiring you, I could be taking you in my organization. So what are the plus that you have studied about the company? Now a couple of you, can you please answer that those who have gone for the interview for internship, did you study about the company before that?
Yes, I did. Yes.
What are the aspects that you studied? Yes?
Like what kind of technologies do they work in, like
Yes? And?
Like what are the technologies do they work in, and how's the, like, what's the behavior of the management? Does the management have any clear idea, like what they are trying to implement, what their product is?
Have you checked about the founders? Who are the founders?
Yes.
The founders' background? Right? So, any of you from here?
Thank you.
taught in this language. Okay, that's a very good question. Anything else?
How could I improve the performance in the sector?
Yes, yes, that is also. Yes. And anything else? That's a direct question. Okay, not bad. You can ask that. You can ask that. Yes. 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 So don't forget to ask this question. That you can ask. You can ask that.
International NGO Soka Gakkai International, who has
true self, that will be reflected, that will be tested. Okay? So the color, the dress code, the attire, the communication, the conviction in yourself, that will take you.
But I'm
really very happy to interact with all of you, finding your communication skills. Because a lot of you, they didn't, but I was quite happy with your communication skill. So please keep it up, and those who feel that they are yet to develop them, please do the homework, read English newspaper, read loudly, listen to English news channel, which would improve. So thank you so much. And always a smile on your face. That's it. That's it.